Hello friends, good evening. This is Bhupati. This is part 5 of the video series LingQ. I recommend you to watch the part 1, that is LingQ in the context of UiPath, before watching this video so that you can understand what is actually LingQ is. From this video, we will start writing LingQ queries, and firstly we will see about aggregate operations. Friends, just consider this is our input array. I have 6 elements. And I want to know the sum of these elements. What actually you will do? Just forget about LingQ. Without LingQ, how will you get the result? You will use for each loop, and then for each loop you will add the every number with other number, and finally you will get the result. Correct? If you use the LingQ, you can just type in this input array dot sum. Now you will get the answer. You no need to use the for each loop at all. Okay, now we will see another example. This is our input array. Now I want to sum the numbers which is greater than 30 from this collection. What are the numbers greater than 30, friends? 40, 50, 60. Okay, I want to sum only the numbers greater than 30. Okay, how will you do this without LingQ in UiPath? You will drag and drop a for each loop, and then you will iterate the elements in this input array, and then what you will do, you will use another condition, if condition, and you will filter if the number is greater than 30, then you will apply the sum operation. If you use the LingQ query, we can just bring this result in one line. How? You see input array, because we need to filter the data from the data source only. Here our data source is our input array. Now I will use the var extension method, function x greater than 30. Friends, this is called as lambda expression. I have explained it in detail in part 1. I request you to watch that video before watching this video, then you will be able to understand easily. Anyway, I will just explain shortly what actually it is doing. This is the collection we are passing in the first parameter, this whole collection. Okay, and then second parameter, just we are filtering the collection by using this condition. Okay, this parameter must return the boolean value, otherwise it will give the compiler error. Dot, after filtering the data, I am using the sum extension method. Now this query, what actually will do it, first it will filter the data which is greater than 30, and then applying sum. We use mainly LingQ query to filter the data, friends. Okay, now whatever you achieved using here in UiPath, we achieved using in one single line of query. Okay, now let us see another example. Just consider my input array is input array equal to 1, 4, 6, 8, 9, 7, 13. Now I want to sum the numbers, that is, I want to sum only even numbers, okay, not any odd number. How will you write the query for this? Input array dot where function. Friends, this x is a range variable, it can be anything. I can use s also, okay, yes. What is even number? How will you identify even number in programming? We'll use modulus operator. It returns the remainder of the division operation. If the remainder is 0, then we consider that number is even number. So s mod equal to 0. Now we filter the data from this input array, that is, we filter the even numbers from the input array. After I am applying the sum extension method, so this single line of query will return the expected result. Now we will see aggregate extension method. This is our collection of strings, India, Australia and Japan. We want to convert this string list into single string. Okay, India, Australia, Japan. And this is our aggregate extension method. Aggregate extension method contains three overload methods, and this is based on the first two overload method. I will explain that in detail when we use this example in UiPath Studio. And what actually this func delegate type doing is, in the first, it contains actually it passing the three parameter. First two parameter will take as input, and the third parameter will be written back as accumulated value. That is, in here A contains the value India and B contains the value Australia. Okay, so when next time it iterates, India and Australia will be the value of A and the value of B will be Japan. So finally it will return the accumulated value as India, Australia, Japan. And there is one more overload method for this extension method aggregate. That is, the first parameter you can set the seed value. This seed value is initial accumulator now, and then you can use the func delegate type, whatever the delegate type you used here, and this sum operations will be based on this integer 5. Now in this variable A, 5 will be passed, and B, this 1 will be there in the variable B. Now A plus B first will give 6, and then next time it iterate, the A value contains 6, and then this B variable contains a value 2. Like this, finally it will return the result as 15. Now let us go to the studio. Now first we will see simple sum. We are going to apply the sum extension method directly on the collection. So this is our input array, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 5 elements I have. What I am doing, input array, dot sum. Okay, friends, you need to first observe this intelligence, okay. From this intelligence, you can guess what actually the variable should be on the left hand side, because it is saying, it is summing the value and returning a integer. Okay, so this total counts is actually a integer variable. If you use any other string or any double, then it will throw the error, cannot implicitly convert from integer to string. Or if you, even if it use it as a collection variable also, it will throw an error, because this expression returns an integer, so this must be an integer value. So total counts is an integer value. Now we are displaying the result in a message box. Now I will execute here. Just it will return 150. Next we will see how to filter the numbers greater than 30 and to sum the data. Now we are going to see how to filter the data which is greater than 30 and sum them. I will drag and drop and assign activity. So our collection is input array dot. We need to use the where extension method to filter the data greater than 30. After filtering the data, I need to use the sum extension method. So this is our input collection, and this input collection we are filtering the data by applying the condition y greater than 30. We are collecting the result in total counts. Now I am running this, it will display the result 90, because only two numbers are there greater than 30, that is 40 and 50. It is summing the numbers and displaying the result. Now we will see the same logic without link U here. This is our input array collection, same 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and we are using for each loop to iterate the elements in our collection, and after that we are using an if condition to check if any of the number is greater than 30, then we are summing them. Now I will run this. So without link you also we got the same result, and actually when you observe, we didn't find any difference in execution time, correct? Both the logics returned the result in 1 second, but actually when you used to filter the data from the huge volume of data, that is, you have just an example, you have lakhs of data rows in an Excel, then when you use the filter data table activity, and also when you use the link you,
Then LeanQ query will be much more faster than in filtering the data than using the filter data table activities. Okay, you just remember this. I will try to reproduce such scenarios and I'll also explain in the upcoming videos. Let us see how aggregate operation works on a string array. This is our string array, contains four countries: India, Australia, Japan, Singapore. Now I drag and drop an assign activity. I am going to apply aggregate extension method on the data source string array. This is our collection. Now I will type aggregate. Friends, you see that the moment I type the aggregate extension method, it is displaying three overload methods. That is a different way we pass the parameter and get the output. Now we concentrate on the first two overload method. Here you can see it is returning finally a string value, and we need to check what are the parameters we are passing this func delegate type. Okay, now let us go to the Visual Studio. I'll right click on this aggregate extension method, go to definition. You can see here also we can see three overload methods available for this extension method aggregate. So now let us see the first one. This is the first overload extension method we are seeing. This is the func delegate type. I'll right click on this, go to definition. You can see it is taking two parameter as input. You can see, identify that with the keyword in, and giving that one result as output. That is, this aggregate method works by calling this func delegate type one time for each element in the data source. Now we'll go back here, function a comma b, a plus b. So friends, what actually happens here? In A, the value India will be assigned, and in B, Australia. Now it will happen, and the result will be India, Australia. Next time when the delegate type func is called, the India, Australia will be the input for A, and the B value will be Japan. So like this, it will iterate every time for each element in this data source, and finally will return the result. So it is returning as one string. Okay, so I'll just use a string variable here. I'll use string aggregated value. Now what will be our result, friends? India, Australia, Japan, Singapore, correct? Now I will execute this. You can see India, Australia, Japan, Singapore, but there is no comma in between the countries. Now let us set comma and re-execute. Here okay, now friends, we executed using the first two overload method. Now I want this string to be reversed. That is, India, Australia, Japan, Singapore, now it is there. Now I want the string to be reversed. What can we do, friends? We can just simply reverse this value. Now I will rerun. Now you can see the value is reversed, Singapore, Japan, Australia, because it is appended from the last. This is the aggregate extension method we used using the first two overload method. Now let us check the second overload method. Now I have a string array which contains three countries: Australia, Japan, and Singapore. Friends, just note that India is not included in this country list. I have declared another string variable, seed parameter, and I have included the value as India for this string variable. Now string array dot So friends, now what we are going to do, we are going to invoke the second overload method. So this is the second overload method. and it takes the first parameter we assign as the seed value, okay, and not the first parameter from the data source. In the first overloaded method, our string array contains four countries: India, Australia, Japan and Singapore. And the first parameter there is India. But here the first parameter is whatever the value we are giving for this seed parameter. That is the first element, okay. And then remaining it will perform the same aggregate for operation and it will return the result back. Now what we are going to do, string array. Now first thing is seed parameter. What is the value in seed parameter, friends? India, okay, comma. Now it will return the same value as India, Australia, Japan and Singapore. Now I will run this. You can see now India is included in the result because it take the this link query just taken this first seed parameter as the seed value and then it will append the remaining elements. Now let us see the third overloaded method. Now I have the same string array, Australia, Japan, Singapore. This is our string collection. Our seed parameter values India. Now what we are going to do, we are going to see the third overload method, okay. Now we will drag and drop and assign activity. What is, friends, our collection name? String array dot aggregate. First two overload method we completed and second also is on example. This is the third one. Now you observe for this third overload method the result is based on this function, that is final one, result selector. How I am saying this, friends, just to see this last one as t result. That means whatever the value is returned back in this t result is nothing but the type of the return value of the method. Okay, this is our result. Okay, that's why it is saying as t result. So for this overload method, the result is based on this func delegate expression. That's why it is mentioned as result selector. Now let us see the parameters what it takes. First thing is the we can specify a seed value as initial accumulator, okay, that we already saw how can we give the initial seed value as accumulator. Second one is this func delegate type just applies accumulator function over a sequence. That is the whatever we saw in the second overload method. It takes input and appends the strings and returns back, okay. Finally is the result selector. Friends, you see here it is taking only two parameters, okay, but earlier we saw function delegate type was taking three parameter, okay, but here it takes two parameter. One is input and another one is output. This output is our result. Now I'll go to the Visual Studio, right click on this aggregate extension method, go to definition. Friends, under enumerable class only all the extension methods will be available. That's why it is under the class enumerable. Now this is our third overload method, correct? And then here we need to check this one. So first one is the initial accumulator, what we are giving in seed value. This is the usual accumulator function that we saw. We are giving function of a comma b and then a plus b we given. That is the this func delegate type will do that one. And finally this is the additional one, this is a result selector, okay. Now it takes only two parameters. I'll just right click on this, go to definition. One is input and another one is output. This is our result, okay. Whatever the value is this func delegate type returns, that is the result. That's why it is displaying here, you can see in third overload method as t result. Now I will show that you can understand. Now what you are going to write the query. Now what is our collection, string array dot create. So we are seeing third overload method. First parameter is seed parameter comma func delegate type to apply the augmentor function. See, the moment you type comma now, it automatically show the intelligence of the third overload method result selector. Okay, this func delegate expression is for the result selector. Now it takes two parameters. In this A, it contains the accumulated value, that is India, Australia, Japan, Singapore. I want to get only the country India. A dot substring 0,5. Now okay, string aggregated value. Now I will run this aggregate with result selector. Okay, it is same. Now we get the result only as India. Okay, if I want the country Australia along with India, then I just go to this substring 0,14. Okay, now if I run, you'll also get the country Australia along with India. Okay friends, this is a three overload methods for aggregate extension method. Friends, I want to tell one more thing. This is the .NET code in Visual Studio. Okay, here also we are using aggregate extension method, and this is the lambda expression here. Friends, this is the based on C sharp. UiPath is built using VB.NET, that's why we are using this lambda expression, function of a comma b a plus b. This lambda expression is exactly similar to this one. Okay, this is VB.NET syntax and this is C sharp syntax. This is called as lambda operator. Now if we run this, we will get the same result, that is 10. It will add all the values and return it. Now I will run, you can see 10 is the result. If you are giving the seed value here, just we can give here, you can see it automatically populates the extra overload method, what how it populated in UiPath Studio. Now again if we run, it will take the first value as initial accumulator, this one 10, and then apply the aggregate operation over this sequence and the result will be 20. Friends, based on the collection, the return type also will vary. For example, now we have a collection called input array. It is a collection of integer. Okay, dot aggregate. Now you can see it is returning as integer. Okay, like this, whatever you use, okay, if it is integer, it will return as integer. If you use the double, then it will return the value as double. For example, I will give the seed value as 5.5 comma. You see immediately the intelligence changed. It is returning the final result as double. So your left hand side of the assign activity must be of double data type. If you use the integer data type, then you will get the error, validation error. Friends, in this video we saw all the overload method for aggregate extension method. And then we also saw some other extension methods like minimum, maximum, count, and the average extension method just gives the average of this input collection, and the return type of average is double. So your left hand side of the assign activity must be of data type double, otherwise it will throw validation error. Friends, usually we use LingQ query to filter the data from data table in most of the real time projects. So in next video we will start apply LingQ in data table. So if you don't have Visual Studio installed, just go to the Microsoft site and you can see all the extension methods under system.linkq here. If you click on aggregate, you can see the overload methods available here, and also it is explained in detail here. Whatever the extension methods available there, you can see the corresponding overload methods. For example, if we check, click on concat, there is no overload method for this. Distinct, you can see two overload methods are available. Like this, for whatever the extension method you want to know, you can go to this site and check it out. Friends, hope this video will be helpful to you. If you like this video, please subscribe and support our channel and share this video to your friends. Thank you.